Lawyers how Trump could stealthy fire Mueller, or get rid of Rosenstein in the process. Over the weekend, Democrat lawmakers, Trump-obsessed Hollywood stars, and left-leaning grassroots activists furiously circulated the rumor that the president was going to fire Mueller before Christmas. CNN reported Monday that Trump is quietly telling confidants that the special counsel is set to release a letter clearing him of any wrongdoing in the Russia probe. The news was followed up by more chatter about the investigation likely stretching far into 2018. If such is the case, does the Trump legal team need to seriously consider firing Mueller? Who is to say they don't already have a plan in place? Lawyer Ellerinanos offers up a fairly simple, yet politically explosive way of stealthy, firing Mueller or getting rid of Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein in the process. Ellerinanos writes at Law and Crime Sessions, likely recognizing an impending SH storm from its inception, recused himself from the Russia investigation. For that one matter, Rosenstein is the top dog. We've opined many times here at Law and Crime that as all things Russia continue to heat up, we expect Trump to fire, or at least effectuate the firing of, Special Counsel Robert Mueller. If Trump were to insist that Mueller go, it would likely be Rosenstein who'd get the call. Trump, you see, likely lacks the legal ability to fire Mueller himself, while 45 would be almost certain to declare his power limitless. The optics of firing Mueller directly may actually go beyond what even Trump is willing to tolerate. The AG, on the other hand, or here, the DAG, clearly has the authority to fire Mueller. Whether Rosenstein would be willing to do so, though, is clearly another matter entirely. Should Trump direct Rosenstein to fire Mueller, Rosenstein would likely face the same choice Cox did, comply or resign. And it sure looks like Trump is setting the wheels in motion that he wants Rosenstein out. If Rosenstein finds himself on the chopping block, Trump may move on to the next target, searching for someone to do his bidding. Judicial Watch President Tom Fitton believes Nano's course of action may not even be necessary, saying in recent days that he is increasingly convinced Mueller will resign. "I am increasingly convinced that Mr. Mueller will resign," Fitton tweeted Sunday. The most likely scenario is President Trump will keep Mueller where he is, as he told the press over the weekend. Yet, with mounting evidence the Russia probe may be tainted by political bias and more recently, have reportedly obtained transition emails unlawfully, at some point White House lawyers must say enough is enough. According to Axios boss Mike Allen, Special Counsel Robert Mueller secretly got his hands on many tens of thousands of emails exchanged by Trump transition officials. Trump lawyer Corey Langhofer penned a blistering response to the news, accusing Mueller of unlawfully obtaining transition documents. The question is, what is President Trump's red line Mueller must not cross?